Oh, sure, we're Christmas jerseys. Sorry. No, I think I'm okay. Take out Caspi. Who do I have to deal with?
Christmas Day here on 2K Sports. We want to wish each and every one of you a Merry Christmas.
This
is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony.
Who's that? Oh, it's Dante.
Western Conference battles always fun. This time it's the Los Angeles Lakers intent on protecting home court.
Oh, Joakim.
This is the first season matchup for them against the Clippers team.
Yep.
Last year they were humiliated in their matchup, losing every game in four tries.
God, it's so slow.
Los Angeles. Exum is out there with Ron Shumpert. And it's Rudy Gobert. Then there's Batum. And it's Davis at the power forward. So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles.
And, you know, sorry.
Guys, Dante Exum is such a fluid, versatile athlete, really shows great promise, has tremendous size and length for a point guard, can also play the two. His rookie season last year, though, a mixed bag.
Alright, guys. Let's see what we got here.
For Dante Exum, Greg, last season he didn't shoot the ball that well, and his turnover rate was what you might expect from a rookie, but his defense was good. In fact, borderline excellent at times.
That's a great point, Kevin. And you know what I like about Exum, when his shot wasn't falling, you know, he didn't allow
Kobe
to contribute, and that's the kind of attitude that so many scouts got excited about when they were talking about this guy in the first place.
And there's the feed to Davis.
Okay.
Gobert. And he goes in for the dunk.
Really good awareness right there on the assist.
Outside Jennings. Gasol up top. At the elbow, it's Noah. Kicks it out to Jennings.
Oh, bad pass, but it's okay. It's okay.
Good. Kobe's got his second bucket of the night.
Oh, that is just weak defense there. I'm pretty sure that was not the plan.
I didn't even bump into Anthony.
And he can time his passes so perfectly. Wow, what an assist.
Jennings kicks it to Noah.
Oh, shit.
Try Gasol.
Oh, wait, that wasn't to him. The fuck?
Noah again. Gobert. Just five to shoot.
Here's Kobe!
Bryant got six.
Get that! Yeah, the play is not even to Kobe. It's just that broken plays. I'm like, alright, Kobe has to do the broken plays.
Rarely has a season where his team doesn't meet expectations.
Los Angeles on D.
Oh, there you go.
Rush with the steal. Ryan again, Shumpert.
What is that shot? I don't know that shot. There to take the lead. It's a weird shot. Oh, I knew it. I was damn
it. Win mark as a coach last season. He's climbing the ladder in career wins.
Yeah, and you know, I don't know that Doc oftentimes gets enough credit for the type of coach he is. I mean,
oh shit, what was that?
Well over 500 in terms of his career win percentage. And how about over 500 in playoff games as well?
Damn.
To Batum. That's in there. Davis with the assist. Batum's got his first 2 points of the night. Right wing. Jennings dishes to Gasol.
Yeah.
Count that one. And the Clippers have possession. Exum with it. He dishes it to Davis. To the middle.
Oh. For it. Oh, if it wasn't for... God damn it. That's very unfortunate.
Gobert
damn it.
Got 6 points.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Purposeful passing it is, partner. Their last 10 points have all come off assists.
Oh.
It's Gasol missing.
And if the shot's not there, you've got to understand that. Move the basketball.
Yeah, exactly. And I'm not quite sure what his mindset or what he was thinking there. I mean, that was just a terrible shot.
It's tipped. Stolen by Noah. Here's Jennings.
Oh!
Pass and it goes straight to the bucket for
He's a bad boy.
Jennings has got his first points of the game.
That is such good work to make this a one-possession game. Terrific steal.
Oh my God.
It's one thing to
do you wipe past that
to so alertly turn it into a transition opportunity, even better.
Shot clock at 6. And stolen by Jennings.
Oh.
A piece of it.
Oh, these picked the best pass for you.
On the wing, Shumpert. Jennings kicks to Rush to the paint.
Oh,
it's Gasol.
Shit.
Missing. It's incredible to think that Pau Gasol last year.
What?
High in points
really?
For as long Clark as he's played.
What?
He had a 46-point game in January.
Yeah, that's 46 points for Pau.
To oh, God.
Go with 18 rebounds. I mean,
right.
You rarely see a player of his age putting
Look
up
at that.
A high like that.
And that is good. Jennings has got his second bucket of the game to go. Gobert, the screen. Exum kicks to Davis. Right side, Batum. 6 on the shot clock. The dish to Shumpert.
No way.
Here's Exum. No good on the shot, a bit long that time.
That's not a sight you see very often. I mean,
aye. He's a great feel for supposed to cut,
shot,
dude.
Especially when he's open.
Oh my God.
Noah.
And one. Oh, fuck. Alright, I haven't played Pau in a long time. His free throw is still the same. Alright.
Even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
There we go.
No question about it, Greg. I mean, a ton of contact and a good call by the official.
Damn, my team is slow.
He does not look like your typical big man up there at the line.
Should have more speed.
He has an excellent stroke and a percentage.
Oh, no.
That's exactly what you need to do.
It is. I mean, no reason to back off and give him the layup. I mean, much better off making him
get that shit.
Line.
He doesn't get the second one. Smith wide open.
JR swish.
Just 4 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Deep two.
Oh, field. No.
It's been a high competitive game through the first quarter of play. Lead by 2.
I'll tell him. I'll tell him.
And we're ready to get rolling once again here for our Christmas Day matchup. And taking a look at the Lakers' performance here, what have they been doing or not doing in the game?
Yeah.
I just really like what we're seeing from a defensive standpoint. Forcing a
yeah, I saw that.
With those quick hands.
Yeah, those active hands, Greg, have produced a number of steals early. They've been very aggressive.
Here are the 5 the Clippers have to start the
Oh, season. Kobe.
Carroll is out there.
He's so graceful with it.
And it's Green, and there's Bismack Biyombo, and it's right in at the
one. Oh, you have that. You have that one. And then oh, okay.
Game
I'm surprised.
For the Lakers.
They've come out in attack mode on the defensive end.
Oh.
Applied pressure.
Oh no! I wait too
Another
long.
Big aspect of their game tonight has been the fast break.
Yeah, I was trying to get in front of him. He's not fast enough.
Excellent work there in transition.
Yeah, I think it's always better to go early in transition to attack when it's there, because oftentimes you can beat the defense down the floor.
Jennings hits the Gasol.
Ah, shit.
And it's Anthony Davis with the rebound.
Get back court.
Even having the best of game from the floor, it hasn't seemed to hurt him.
And guys, the Lakers
mismatch.
Were just a completely
I see it.
Team after Kobe.
Oh, yeah.
Not so much in results, but just in how they played on the floor. They actually fared better without Kobe than most thought they would.
Shot on the wing, and the shot falls short this time. Jennings kicks to Kobe. To the middle.
Oh, damn. That chemistry.
And nobody got
I don't know, man.
The defender stepping up to challenge him on that drive. To the 10.
And Greg, he says, thank you very
much. Oh!
Sails in for the flush.
And those are the kind of sequences that tell you why the.
Oh, wow. I hate that shit, man. Really? He was like in the middle of about to dunk it, too. He was right there.
And for the Lakers without Kobe last season, it was really a start.
He was about to dunk it. And he gets contact.
Carry their offense. It took a group effort.
Well, you know, it was almost April, Kevin, before somebody surpassed Kobe in field goal attempts on the team.
Oh, shit.
It'll be interesting to see
how
they
build
the offense
this year.
And here is Los Angeles now. The Clippers get in the bucket. Just four to shoot. And Bryant gets to Gasol.
There we go.
There's the bucket. Good.
Shit.
Gasol's got the lead up to six now for the Lakers.
Well, guys, they've shown some great passing on their last few trips now on the floor. Excellent.
Four straight passes leading to scores. Great team play.
Carroll dishes to Davis.
Oh, my God.
Kobe, the best.
Fuck.
Baseline J.
Oh, man. What the hell? It's supposed to drive in.
Shot is off.
Coaches just love players who they can count on to give that effort defensively.
And he clearly is one of those guys, Greg. We saw it right there. Nice work forcing that miss.
Davis kicks to Biombo. It's stolen by Bryant.
Yeah, Jennings can finish, man. Jennings can finish.
And now it's an 8-point Laker lead.
Oh, how about the floater there? Nice.
Oh, you shoot that. Oh, shit. I need help. Oh, you have that.
Huge moment for Kobe last season before the injury. I mean, he passed the great Michael Jordan on the all-time scoring list.
Outside for Davis.
Yeah.
And the three ball is good. Davis has got his third basket of the night right there.
Great opportunity right there. He's got such tremendous length. He can just rise up and get separation for the three.
Bryant in the corner. He kicks it to Rush.
Oh man, that's bad. That was bad.
No good from outside. For Kobe, that was him moving into the third spot ahead of Michael Jordan. Says a lot, Clark, about where he stands.
Oh.
And you look at it, he is first among perimeter players now in that regard.
We good.
He's clearly on a very short list of the greatest.
Oh, that's, he's speaking Spanish right now.
And guys, right now the defense,
the chemistry,
not there. Can't afford too many of those in a close game like this.
Yeah, Jay, you're right. Almost a free run, don't you think? Clark to the hoop for him there.
Momentum can swing on plays like that, Kevin, especially when the finish has that.
Oh, God.
And Brandon Rush gets the whistle that time. A platoon swap here for the Lakers. Big group substitution here for the Clippers. Rudy Gobert, he's checked in for Davis. Batum comes in for Damari Carroll. Shumpert, he's checked in for Daniel Green. And it's Exum in for Wright. To the left side wing.
Who's here? JR.
Exum dishes to Gobert.
Uh-oh, the future is here. The Filipino.
absolutely insane with that dunk.
Well, now they're starting to rub it in, aren't they?
Oh, shit, I thought it was third quarter.
That was a Kodak moment right there. The more plays they make like that, the more they'll have these guys on the ropes.
Gobert, the pass to Shumpert. Six to shoot. Down low.
Oh, my God.
And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. Batum's got six.
Oh, Jordan Clarkson, man. You fast. Are you so fast?
And decision-making for them offensively.
Absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding, and they're piling up the assists.
Fuck.
No good on that last second attempt there. And we're through the first half of basketball here, and what's been a good one.
Might put Clarkson instead of Kobe. That speed.
Live from the Staples Center, you're watching 2K Sports.
Your safety is our number one concern. In the event of emergency evacuation of Staples Center becomes necessary, please walk calmly out of the way of the facility.
All right, Staples Center. Welcome back, folks. Thank you for tuning in to the NBA on 2K Sports as we get set to get going once again. Hey, during the break, players getting a chance to refuel with some Gatorade as there is more basketball in store.
Gasol doing all sorts of things. He has 12 points and a couple of nice
steals.
Damn,
Gasol is a player of the game right now?
As his stats are, what I've liked most is just the effort he's put into this game.
And Clark, he's worked his tail off at the offensive end, and his D, it has been.
Come on. Oh.
Welcome back, everyone. The second is about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far.
My guys.
And what about Pau Gasol? Oh. I mean, he's been sensational.
And in terms of points in that first half, you know, he's now at a
point geez.
You expect him to perform that way.
And Greg, that tells you all you need to know about what a talent he is. I mean, I'll bet he adds a lot more to his totals after the break.
Yeah, that's what I want. That's what I want. That's what I want. That's what I need. That's what he does.
The pivot spot, manning the middle.
Fuck. Because Noah, too slow.
Clark, another milestone for Kobe Bryant.
Damn, I need a center. It's pretty fast.
3,000 points and 6,000.
Oh, that's not what I want.
Has ever done that.
Well, it's rare
get back.
Of that volume reach an assist.
Yeah.
High, but I think it speaks to Kobe's passing ability, which is undervalued and overshadowed at times.
Oh, okay.
And if you're just joining us, we played over a minute here in the third. Bryant is doubled. Just five on the clock.
Oh, what the hell? Rest everyone. Everyone rest. They're all there.
Davis.
Oh. Damn.
Man, he got fancy.
Man, we slow.
With that one, didn't he?
Yeah, maybe trying
to. I was thinking about hype and not speed. Damn, I should
have. I tell you what, I like that though, guys.
All right, we're good.
Might not want you to make a play like that, but I tell you what, when you
okay, we got it. It's okay.
Like that, I say go for it.
Here we go. Oh, fuck, I think I fall for it. Damn it.
There to create the shot, but it's no good.
Oh, what the hell? He just stopped. Okay.
That's what the box score says, but still anybody's game.
Yeah, fuck. I wish I had Swaggy P. He'll buy me out right now.
I think some urgency from him there.
Man, I think he's sensing that this is a critical time in the game, fellas.
Now here's Jennings. 6 points for him. Gasol. Nice pass, nice catch, and a resounding dunk.
Guys, he's
yeah, why are we still going back? Damn. Ball goes up in the air, you go back. Easy.
I don't think there was anyone, and I mean anyone, that could have stopped him on that one.
I tell you what, I'm glad.
Oh, you know his spin move? Oh, damn. Never mind. You don't know this spin move.
Now, here's Gasol.
Okay, fuck, I forced that one shit. Fuck.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near
the damn.
Over.
And Batum throws it down.
Incredible timing on the alley-oop.
He absolutely hammered
and
it.
One. Ah, damn.
Right there, because that could be the one that.
Yeah, I've been making some crazy and one plays with Kobe for no reason.
Lakers shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
That's off. I knew it. I leased too early. Fuck.
Davis a season ago just took the league by storm. I mean, jaw-dropping numbers. I think you could.
Oh God.
If Wilkins' record had been a little better, he probably would have won the league MVP.
Looking at who's out there now for the Lakers. Channing Frye's.
Oh, don't let him break your ankles.
Heskey comes in for Kyle Gasol. J.R. Smith's checked in for Brandon Rush.
Oh, that's J.R. Swish, baby. Damn. That's space. That's space.
Anthony Davis last season, far and away the best player efficiency rating wise in Clark the NBA.
Yeah, that's called PER, player efficiency rating, one of the four best marks in NBA history for Davis alongside Chamberlain,
no way.
Jordan, and LeBron.
No
Davis.
Way.
And you really thought that was going to be a gimme, but unable
to. Oh, fuck. JR needed that.
Angry self-talk for himself after that miss.
Al Batum.
There we go.
Following the miss by J.R. Smith from deep. Smith on the wing for the lead.
I need that. There we go.
Smith's got two now from beyond the arc in the third for the Lakers. Let's look at the energy stats. How the hustle game.
Do you have Danny Green?
For the Lakers.
The activity level shit. Defensively, I've really been impressed with. There's been an
oh, shit. Oh my God! Nope.
A heads up aggressive play right there. Saw the smaller man on him and took it straight to the basket.
Help me! Damn it. Oh, Caspi? Oh, Caspi! Deal! That's why I drafted you!
Over and over and over. And they may have found the Achilles heel of this defense. That was their ninth straight point from beyond the arc.
Go, Peace. Go, Peace.
12 points for
Aw, damn.
That's good. Batum's got 14.
No Peace, I guess.
58 seconds left in the third quarter. World Peace with a screen on right.
And one. Aw, fuck.
Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Clearly a foul.
You better make those.
Yeah, he took a shot there. Earned those free throws.
Clippers were so strong on the road.
Oh my God. Late? Late?
On the road. And actually they scored more points away from Staples than in it.
Especially down the stretch, Kevin. I mean, they finished the regular season with eight straight.
Damn, what a mismatch over there.
Their home court advantage in the first round. Superb.
Biombo kicks to Carroll.
Nope. Gotta work for it.
On the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Oh, he don't want it. He doesn't want it, guys.
That pushed their road record to 26-15. That was.
Does he? Okay.
In the league, also set a franchise high for road wins.
Joakim Noah's checked in for the Lakers.
Shit, I might put fucking Clarkson at.
You know,
two.
What's amazing about the Clippers on the road last year, guys, was the context. I mean, they had a bunch of back-to-back games and went.
Ah, fuck, no Curry status.
Back-to-back.
I got no Curry.
Came on the road.
And Wright kicks to Batum. And the wide-open shot
there
from
you
Green.
Go.
No good on the triple. Inside. Here's Smith.
What the hell? Why gave me a jumper?
From Green.
No animation, just give me a jumper.
An exciting neck and neck game.
That's cool.
Lead by one. And we're coming right back after this.
So it's like that.
Quarter underway. We've got a great game on our hands as we welcome you back. The fourth quarter of action getting started. Okay.
So it's like that. Oh,
Gatorade all fueled up and ready to go for this fourth quarter. Taking a look at Los Angeles. We've got Green. Jamari Carroll is out there with Davis. Then it's Exum. And it's Biombo, the five spot.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And the Lakers have possession. After the Clippers pick up two. Toby.
There you go. There you go.
Is good.
I noticed it. I'm like, why is he in front of him? I'm like, okay.
By one.
Gosh, damn, why are we slow? God damn it.
Competition in this one.
I agree with you, Kevin. I mean,
we're slow.
Changes really kind of tells the story of this game.
Yeah, 7 already in the game, and I think it shows you how well these two teams match up with one another.
Come on, come on, come on.
Here's Jennings after Dante Exum's bucket.
Oh, shit.
Jennings kicks it to Noah. Down low. Here's Gasol.
There you go, pal. There you go, pal.
And the deeper we get into this game, it seems like the more the offenses are in rhythm.
Without question, I mean, both of these teams are firing on full broadband bandwidth.
Dude, no one needs to stick to his guy. Stay in front of him, man.
Just a great, great battle.
God damn.
These two teams are waging here today.
Boy, it sure is, and I'm getting the sense that this game could end up being decided by just one or two plays down the stretch.
Oh, Kobe over Anthony? Oh, my God.
Nice assist by Jenny.
Deal, that's on the stream, dude.
Now, here's Exum. He's guarded by Jennings. It's a nice passing here.
Oh, the defense is real.
Watch the line there. That'll be a backcourt violation.
I like this, Kevin. This is a lot better ball control from them, as they really haven't had any turnover problems in a bit.
Gobert, he's checked in for the Clippers. Shumpert comes
in. Aye, yeah, that's not what I want.
Now, here's Bryant. Takes it from
not what I want.
Kicks it out to Jennings.
Fuck. And it's off. Getting greedy.
And here's the fast break. Davis leading the way. A huge slam. The perfect end of the fast break. Time running low, guys. And somebody has got to win this one.
This game, as close as it's been, you really hate to see it come to an end.
I agree.
Yeah, well, who knows? We might need.
Oh, no.
It's been that kind of a game.
To Carroll. Outside jumper. Gobert.
Fuck. A mismatch.
Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
Come on, guys.
That's
still
what
got
I like.
Time.
A nice, strong finish inside.
That's what he does. He's
oh.
That dunker mentality.
My goodness, physicality.
Oh, that's pow, man. That's pow.
Biggest defender. I mean, you
and look at that, we slow. We are slow.
Talk about putting something extra
Fuck.
On it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, Clark, you know, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space.
I'm startled that he would even
there you
try
go.
Something like that at this stage of the game. Perfect screen there. Set him up with a terrific look.
Yeah, I like the fact that the setup was good.
No way. Get those rebounds.
You also have to look at the fact the defender didn't do his job as well as he could have.
Oh, fuck. I missed. Oh, what? Oh, really? I really say right when he pulled up. Like, he was rising. That was so early.
Got 5 assists tonight.
I guess that's his hot spot.
Exum pass it to Gobert. Gobert, the screen. And Shumpert kicks to Gobert.
Wow.
Timely screen.
Wow.
He took it all the way.
That's all I can say.
Gobert
wow.
Got it all tied up now for the Clippers. Lakers have gone 6-9 on their field goal attempt since the start of the fourth quarter. Gasol screen.
Oh, what?
Davis. Oh, and here comes Carroll all alone.
Oh, my God. Really?
Finish off by Shumpert.
No running, damn. I made a mistake with Brandon Rush. Oh, timeout.
And I love that. I mean, at this stage of a tight game, all too
yeah.
often teams play not to lose, and they wouldn't be in the lead right now if he hadn't taken the chance there.
Anthony Davis really making a difference here.
He's in one heck of a groove with the scoring. They're going to talk it over and try to figure out how to slow him down.
Los Angeles calls timeout. They're down by 2. 1:37 left here in the fourth quarter. And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Gentlemen, Byron Scott had some advice for his team in that last timeout.
Oh, my God.
He told them, this is it, fellas. Let's hit them right out of this timeout. Put some pressure on them. Show them how much you want it. Let's go get it. Guys, he's really exhorting them to give them a burst of energy.
Oh, shit. Too late. I pushed Joakim Noah a long time ago.
By Davis. And Gasol comes to help.
tipped away. Wow, really? Nothing.
To Gobert. Back to Davis. Outside Batum. Five on the clock. Back to Davis. Takes the 13-footer. No points to be had here. Misses for the fifth time in 13 tries.
Wow, really? No, yeah, man, that's it for Grand Rush right now. That's it. That's it. Fuck. Fucking Grand Rush. I thought he can dunk. I thought he's a high flyer too, right? No, not that dude. No, is that the right Grand Rush though on the Warriors, right?
32 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
I thought he could, Oh, is that the other Rush? Wait, who am I talking about? No. There's, who's that other Rush? Oh, that's Barnes. I'm stupid, man. From Warriors? That's Barnes. Fuck. That's my fault.
They're within one possession.
I think we'll see them burn the clock a bit here.
You know, I think that's probably a smart move.
I think so too.
Honestly, just doing what they have.
That was the one. I should have just took it in with Jordan.
That's a good foul, though. I like that. I mean, clock management crucial at this time of the game.
And so they choose to intentionally foul.
Can he shoot? Aw, damn it.
And that makes it a 3-point lead.
Damn.
Throws here. So now it's a 4-point ball game.
And those free throws will mean a ton now. It makes it a 2-possession game.
Oh, gotta foul me on that one.
When Joakim Noah is allowed to heat up, this is what you get.
Oh!
Knocked away. Clarkson.
Oh! Kendall. All right, see, Kurt.
What a bucket at one of the more crucial moments of the game.
Can why he quiet?
And the Clippers.
Oh, this is bad now. I'm gonna choke now. This is not good.
11 seconds left for the fourth quarter.
Fuck the clutchness.
Seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Green dishes to Batum. They could win it.
Oh, damn. Damn.
Big time. Big time.
Incredible.
Heartbreaker. Heartbreaker. Damn.
Wow, what a
I don't know what to say. Clarkson was right there, too.
Game time.
So it's the Clippers taking the win in a close one. This win, such a
heartbreaker. Dude, my team is slow. All right, now. Now I gotta do some trades because my small forward is a weak. Fuck. Weak. Who wants Caspi? He's tired, so I can put Clarkson for that speed. Just in case there's a fast break or like a steal or something, Jordan Clarkson will be there. Who can I get? Fuck, Josh Smith? Josh? Caspi's threes though. Paul Pierce. The fuck? That's Towers? God damn. Someone that could be fast to run back down the court. Cast me? Oh, man. But if I lose another one, then I'm making major trades. But I feel like the real Lakers right now. God damn it. Let's see this. Damn, I'm kind of curious to face Porzingis. Just curious. Oh shit, the Kings. You just played the Kings.
Welcome everyone to this.
That game I had to put on YouTube though. From the capital city of California. Yeah, it was too close.
Looking at Sacramento, they want to turn it around after the loss to the Clippers. And that one a tough loss, too. They ended down only 3 points.
Oh, Lord. I'm already losing.
Sorry effort that they put forth.
Oh, and they got Iggy, too?
That's pretty harsh from you, Greg, but you're right. I mean, too many times we saw them slow to set up and get on deep or late on their rotation. And they paid a big price for it.
There you go.
A chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one.
Get the fuck out of here, dude. Right now,
Jennings out there with Kobe.
No, can't stop that fade, man.
And it's Rush in at the three.
Lakers on D. Yeah, blown up by freaking Kobe Bryant. How difficult volcano last season, starting out by the Bucks.
Even though the team, Greg, around him wasn't very good. But then
damn, it's because that LeBron
fell to pieces.
And when you're a competitor the way this guy is a competitor, you can't stand to lose. So you push your body to the limit to avoid that. But what happens at age 36 when you've got the kind of miles that Kobe Bryant has, you know, you just
oh my God, the chemistry is not there at all. Wow, I can feel this chemistry not going.
Noah the screen, Bryant drives in, Jennings in the corner.
Oh, Jennings! Damn it!
On two or three here to start out the game. Here's Smith.
Really?
The whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
And not the guy you want to see at the line too often. Season numbers has him in the bottom tier of the league.
And you know, that's not the kind of percentage any player wants to see next to
his
name.
Damn, who wants Noah? Who wants Noah, man?
We're not a great team.
Why'd I get this guy?
They had one of their better bench units last season. They led the league in points off the bench, but that was more an indictment.
He's supposed to anchor, but he couldn't play defense that last game.
Firepower of the bench.
Here's Smith, following the basket by Kobe Bryant.
Yeah.
Smith outside. Back to Scola.
Give me those.
Rebound by Noah. Last year, the Lakers did have some firepower off the bench. A lot of players would shift during the year, as you might expect for a team trying to find the right combination.
Yeah, they were also near the top in the league in bench minutes played. So whether you start or come off the bench last year in LA,
all right, very much got to show me something. Show me something, dude. Oh my God, James Harden just takes it over. Joke him, really?
Second basket of the night. Los Angeles has gone 0-3
really?
From 3-point
like that, huh?
Going outside. Here's Gasol.
Oh, Gasol got some fades too, man.
As that one falls.
That time the defenders were a little lazy getting to him.
And it's Smith penetrating. Great defense that time from Noah.
Oh, excellent interior D to force.
Dude, Kendall, I'm a flyer in my park. That's just for freaking Jewry's sake.
Now here's Bryant.
Oh, wide open. Yeah, I changed because his squad's flyers, so yeah. So I'm like, God damn it.
You can't give him.
Gotta leave LA to go to New York.
All it takes to get him in the zone.
Smith dishes to Hart. Down low, out to Smith. Jordan the screen, down to five on the shot clock. No one near. Smith is
wow.
To go. Takes the elbow jumper and dreams it.
And former coach of the year, George Karl, making his way back into the league last season. Kings picked him up halfway through the year to kind of stabilize their coaching situation.
Here's Rush. What? He hasn't scored yet. That I'm sure will change. Ryan against Harden, fires from 14.
Oh, not even a front row. That's cool. Yeah, hella too late. And they got Iguodala.
Carl Gray on the bench, as you mentioned. He has just been a winner, Clark, his entire career.
Well, he's climbing the ladder in the all-time wins category as a coach and also in the cancer survivor.
Yeah, charging.
That also lends itself to having great compassion and respect for George Karl.
As did his son, Kobe.
That's
remember
right.
That? Yeah.
That's right. There's a family affair.
And the Kings will go for a different look here.
Christine, see if I can work with Clarkson Jordan. Starting over Cash Kobe. That speed.
Johnson, he's checked in.
He is a really his three is like a B, but once you get it down, it's so easy.
Channing Frye's checked in for Gasol. Caspi comes in for Brandon Rush. J.R. Smith.
Just like that. Oh, man.
Jordan Clarkson in for Brandon Jennings. For Sacramento, they've gone 4-7 from the field, shooting over 50%.
And they got Chris Kaman? Oh, man.
And here's Smart. Puts it up from 12. Will not go. This is off the front iron. The Lakers trail. And Caspi kicks to Smith.
What the fuck? What is JR's release, man?
Boy, even though he missed, you can't give up that kind of a look very often.
Better to be lucky than good sometimes. Fortunately, they didn't get burned on that one.
Am I about to be 0-3? Yeah, this seems hard to use.
They've established great position inside.
Yeah, just getting the ball into the post.
Oh, no foul.
Number one for them right now.
We've got a 9-second
damn, I might put Kobe at the three if this is going
to
be like this. Oh, damn. I got to put Kobe at the three. This is ridiculous.
Fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
And the Lakers making a change here. Pau Gasol is checked in for Frye. Rush comes in for Caspi. Bryant is checked in for J.R. Smith. And it's Jennings in for Clarkson.
Duncan, Noah, mother. Okay, who wants Noah, man? What's Noah? This guy is like the new McGee right here.
Now here's Smart.
Holy crap, man!
Harden outside. Good.
I know. He's just. Oh man.
6 points for James Harden.
Nice bucket there. I mean, they are.
I should have got Roy Hibbert. I was thinking of Roy. He's a good 2K player, but I don't know. I thought Noah would be that guy.
You know, I think Joe Kiss, Clark for Chicago, being that famished five, especially with Rose back on the court.
There's no doubting that.
Oh, I mean, God.
Even the addition
the
of Gasol
the
with
hell?
His two
out
rings,
here.
The way he left things in L.A., that left him with an appetite that has him still hustling.
Welcome back, folks. We'll see if we're in store for a more tightly contested quarter as we move here into the second.
Get that rebound. I think Pau's going to be my number one guy in this team.
They've been making some really nice passes out there. Excellent passes.
Yeah.
Could set the tone for the rest of the game.
And also, it's been
just
a
seeing the dynamic duo. Clutchness from Gasol.
Well, it's really been about the balance that they've shown.
God damn it, Peace.
Then it's Brandon Bass. Then it's Johnson. And it's Evans in at the four slot. That's the five to begin the second quarter.
Reggie Evans, the ball grabber.
Catching up on the changes for Sacramento.
Hey, let's go.
Jordan's checked in for Bass.
Dude, why are you so slow, Brandon? Holy crap, you are not Barnes at all. God damn it.
Terrific job on both ends of that sequence. Very slick steal and then excellent transition offense.
Really, it all. Oh, freaking DeAndre. Dude, the Kings are stacked. What the hell?
Tell you what, he can do a lot more damage to that rim than that when he wants to.
And you know, Clark, with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one.
Me too.
Well, I tell you what, I'm glad he didn't, because otherwise we'd probably have a 45-minute delay here. He shattered the backboard.
A one near Iguodala as he lets it go. Sacramento gets it back, and DeAndre Jordan
Damn.
Throws it down.
And just another example, Kevin, of how they built this lead just out.
Yeah, if I lose this one, I'm about to play 2K camera. Yeah, get serious.
All the time, fighting to get proper position, then slamming home the putback.
Yep, and if they can maintain this energy level, their lead will be safe.
Six to shoot, and Gasol gets it to go.
Lots of work to clean up, guys.
Looking for coaches that embrace analytics and look at data-driven approaches. Coach Scott is not one of those guys. He's an old-school coach who goes with his own perception.
And former coach of the year, Byron Scott, now with the Lakers. And as you said, Greg, he's not an analytics guy. Clark, I think he's a guy that the eye test for him is huge.
Yeah, he feels a lot. Terrific communicator and storyteller. Great experience as a player and as a champion. And I think that all is evident in his coaching style.
Sacramento making a switch here. Scola's checked in. Iguodala kicks to Smith.
You can't.
Jordan the screen. Smith the pass to Scola.
Fuck that shit.
No good. And the Lakers will go the other way with it. Pass to Kobe. This one for three. That's good for his third bucket. Now 3 for 6 from the field. Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. Smith dishes to Jordan. Great defense that time from Noah.
You know what? His finishing ability, not really at the level that you would expect from a pro.
Damn.
But he's going to have to start playing with more force.
Yeah, dude, Kendall, you think you have a chance this weekend? Quarter,
and they're starting to get on track.
And they're starting to
you really think you have a chance?
They're on fire. I mean, that's what they need.
Damn.
To climb back into this game.
From confidence when that game was luck. Game was the freaking football gods.
Jennings with the ball. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game.
Oh, let's go.
There's the basket.
We'll see. You still have to go another game after that.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda.
Yeah, and it's really fun to see that kind of unselfishness. Really hard not to appreciate all the assists they've racked up.
Chris Kamen has checked in for the Kings. Harden comes in for Joe Johnson. And finished off by Gasol.
And guys, that's a big swing right there. I mean, taking the steal.
So lucky, dude. I was like, right after that one stupid hike that went to Tyler Lockett, it went downhill for Vikings from there. They got rattled. They're like, oh shit, we lost our composure after that. We don't know what to do.
And for Luis Scola, a very different role for him over the last 2 years. I mean, he was a starter for most of his career, then signed with Indiana, who had David West at the
Teddy Bridgewater, he was so smooth in that game. He was smooth.
But he was just used to
the protection was smooth. It was just good. And defense was on point.
They've gone 7-9 in their field goal attempts here in the second quarter. Pretty good offense. Pass to Rush. Fires from deep. Rebound by Smith. Kings have gone just 33% from the field in what's been a cold second quarter for them. Just 3 of 9. On the wing, it's Iguodala. Again, the miss by the Kings. Looking at Los Angeles, they want to turn it around after the loss to Minnesota. And the whistle blows, it's going to be on Ishmael Smith.
Damn.
That's his first foul.
Seahawks, man, you have to go through Packers, and Packers are kind of slumping.
Yeah, it looked like it.
I mean, you have to go with Cardinals.
Slid underneath as he got to the spot too.
They're hungry. They'd be like, damn, we lost that game. They'd be like, we got to get him back.
And Marcus Smart is subbed in for Ish Smith. And Los Angeles will go for a different look here. Channing Frye's checked in for Gasol. Kespi comes in for Brandon Rush. Smith checked in for Kobe. And it's Jordan Clarkson in for Brandon Jennings.
Oh.
Smith against Iguodala. He dishes it to Bass. That's ball.
Bostic.
Nice speed that time from Andre Iguodala. Bass has got
all
the
you know his name
for the Kings. Here's Clarkson. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him.
And no excuse there for missing that one after being freed up by a great pick.
The yeah, Bucks. I mean, oh, Bucks. Oh, that Bucks. Yeah, I was like, what?
Really, I like the movement and communication there.
Here's Noah. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot too. It's going to be on Brandon Bass.
Yeah, easy call.
Yeah, you can hear the smack all the way over here where we are.
The Lakers have shot 1 of 3 from the line tonight, missing 2 early on.
Damn
Reggie
it.
Evans, he's checked in for Chris Kaman.
And you look at Joakim Noah, I mean, one of those hybrid talents. As a center, he gives you the rebound.
You really like Chip Kelly? Are you serious?
Tremendous passing skills and energy, and the energy of a mountain lion.
Clarkson kicks to Smith. And there's the pass to Clarkson.
Over Shanahan?
11 seconds left to play here in the second quarter.
Mike.
And that's good. J.R. Smith for
three. No, it was either Mike Shanahan or Chip Kelly, and it was a 24-hour decision.
Left here in the second.
It was one of them two.
It's stolen by
no.
Smith. A three ball.
No. Not even close. It was either them two. Not even.
The 2K Sports halftime.
The only closest one was Tom Coughlin. We had some interviews with him.
Hello again, everybody. Ernie Johnson here, joined by Shaquille. The Lakers could have gone much better. As hard as they tried to compete, they just... And now, folks, it's just about time for the third quarter to begin. We will see you after the final...
Chip, that Winnie the Pooh bastard.
We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball.
Yeah, I just feel like there's going to be some clash with the with the office.
Sensational.
He created a lot of quality shots for himself in that first half, and he knew when to pass it up when the double team came.
And that led to a very high points per shot number for him. For those of you that are into analytics, that stat really tells how efficient a player has been, and he's been very efficient so far.
And on the floor for Byron Scott as we get into the second half. Rush out there with Pau Gasol. Then there's Bryant. Then there's Jennings.
Right.
And it's Noah in a jump. And so the ball out of bounds. Scola touched it last.
I don't watch Eagles games. I don't know.
Bryant against Harden. Gasol a screen. Shot clock at 5. That's in, coming off an assist by Kobe. Bryant's got.
Yeah, we
got
to run the no huddle offense. You know, dude, Jim Tom Silla tried to do that, and it did not work.
Over those screens.
And Greg, especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
I wonder where's Tom Silla. I got. Should put him back to defensive line coach again.
Outside, Kobe.
Fuck! I knew I released it too early.
Double digits, but it's
man.
No good. The Kings trail by 8. It was a rough year last year for fans
Shit.
In Sacramento, but they still come out here to fill up the stands, Greg, even with their team struggling.
Yeah, the new ownership give them credit. Last year, the Kings marked an 8-year high in terms of attendance. Not bad for a team that really looked to be in the hunt for the postseason, but then just fell apart midway through.
Jennings kicks to Gasol. The 11-footer. That one off the back iron and out. And for Sacramento, they're shooting 48% from the field. Not bad at all. Smith with it. Gasol
no way.
From about 19 feet.
There we
a
go.
Rebound by Kobe Bryant.
The Kings ended at 18-23 here at home. Not a terrible record for them, given how their whole season went kind of up and down and inconsistent. They even had some home cooking in their favor as they were the second best team in free throw differential at home.
I like the recognition of the mismatch there, immediately making the defense pay.
Chip. Oh, man.
Now a timeout called by Sacramento. In addition to going over the game plan and making whatever necessary adjustments have to be made, Greg, this timeout also the time for players to get rehydrated or hydrate for the first time with some Gatorade. Plenty of basketball still to be played here, and they have to get recharged.
That's a great point.
2 years. It's too late, man. I want Anquan to get a ring with us.
Down the stretch of a game, and that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen.
No, he's done. His contract is up. Yeah, that was his last year.
The thing for the Kings to look forward to is the opening of their new arena.
I mean, it would be nice to keep him. He's still a ball. It's just I don't want to pay that much for him.
Any more exciting.
Meta World Peace, he's checked in for Noah. Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Yeah, he can still ball. I wish he could stay.
He said their plan was run their offense through James Harden.
Yeah.
Coach reminded his guys that he is the centerpiece of their offense, and he's the one they want with the most.
Lucky man. There's times where Justin Smith almost got Joe Flacco so many times. He just throws it.
Thank you, Doris. Tipped away. Bryant, that's for two. That's short off the rim. The Kings trail by seven. Johnson outside. Smith on the wing. He's guarded by Jennings. Came in a screen. Smith the pass to King. Great D that time from World Peace. The Lakers have gone 3 of 8 so far in the third quarter, looking to lock
there
in
there.
And he gets it to go. Bryant's got the lead up to 9 now for the Lakers.
And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today.
And guys, Brandon Jennings, some people love his
James Harden
game. Some can't stand it. One of the more polarizing talents in the NBA.
Yeah, I don't think he'll ever shoot for an efficient percentage or become a lockdown defender, Kevin. He's an offensive catalyst. He pushes the action, and he'll go on scoring binges, but I think he does more good than bad with his style of play.
Great positioning on the putback. World Peace has got his first basket.
You know, his positioning near the hoop, always to his advantage. Just a terrific job to tip that one back in.
Smith against Jennings. Harden outside. Off target from outside.
And talking about Brandon Jennings, he has an endless bag of tricks. Keeping the ball literally on a string makes behind the back no look and off the
every
back.
Every time breaks on his ankles, man, the pressure, man.
That unpredictability, though, can make
that's
him
difficult
to
that's the pressure. That's why, like, my shot percentage will go down. That's why I just drive it in. If I break someone's ankle, I just drive it in. I have a better chance in that one.
Came in against Kobe. Kobe draws the double. Down low, World Peace dishes to Gasol.
I do what I want. I do what I want.
On the slam.
Great sequence for them defensively and Clark offensively.
Well, one usually leads to the other, Kevin. That's just good, aggressive, attacking basketball at both ends.
That's tipped. Outside Bryant. World Peace with a screen on Smith. Bryant can't get it to go.
You know, Brandon Jennings is that rare type of difference maker, a guy who can jumpstart your offense without turning the ball over. That's a valuable asset when you're trying to line up the double.
Oh, don't foul.
Can separate in the shot and game clocks. Here's Gasol. Now Bryant. He's got 16. Second chance shot.
Wow.
Rebound by Smith. Harden right side. From 11 feet away. And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. The Kings trail by 12. We've got Scola. Brandon Bass is out there with Evans. Then there's Iguodala. And it's Smart in at the point guard position. So that's the five in the game for Sacramento. Evans against Gasol.
Fuck, man, really? I let Reggie Evans do that to me? First points up on the board here in the fourth for
Sacramento. Left side, Bryant.
Oh, shit.
Again, the miss by Kobe.
And since halftime, he has just been ice cold. Just
you want Blair Witch Project?
To go his way. And that tells you a lot about why the score is where it is. Lazy defense.
That one's good. The Laker lead is cut to just 11 points in the basket from Smart.
Really, really good at recognizing the gaps and getting the ball to the rim.
The drive by Bryant.
Oh, my God.
Steal. Kicks it to Smart. Evans with it. Picked up by Bryant. Noah against Iguodala. Over to the left wing. Bash gets an open look and a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single.
Where are we at? 16 Lakers points. What?
Outside, Kobe. Noah with a screen for Kobe. Noah kicks to Gasol. Good, and a nice assist from Noah.
Damn, my team's ass. I need Dunleavy.
For Pau Gasol. Well, Special K, so many records for Kobe, but one he set last season.
This is that stroke, man.
Misses all time from the floor.
Stroke. You know, he passed the great Hondo. And he's long arms. Can keep up, too. Grand Rush, he can't keep up.
Buckeye, you're right. That's right. Most misses. But you look at the players on that list, a who's who of NBA stars.
And I think Doris Burke has something for us. Of all the mock drafts, I get first round pick, and it was the worst one.
I was able to catch the message George Karl was giving to his team. He told his players, turnovers are killing us right now. We can't keep trying to make the home run play. Settle down, run the offense, and make the simple pass. Kevin, sounds easy enough.
Mm. All right, Doris, thanks.
And, you know, there's all this talk about Kobe now being the leader.
Oh,
of
my
shots,
God.
Having that record, but listen. The guys that are in the top five of that list, all Hall of Fame players. So you don't miss a lot of shots unless your team trusts you to take them, and you're pretty good.
Here's what the Lakers are going with right now. Channing Frye's checked in for Gasol. Smith comes in for Brandon Rush. And it's Clarkson in for Brandon Jennings.
Oh, Channing Frye. I forgot you can shoot threes.
And the Lakers lead by 11.
The three-point shot has been a real weapon for them in the second half.
Yeah, they've really done a good job of creating good looks from the outside, and now they've really got it going.
Bass passes to Iguodala. Six on the shot clock.
Be there, though.
Here's Scola.
Be there.
Can't get it to go. Nice D by Kobe. Stolen
Except
by Smart.
Fucking... Wow.
Iguodala with it. Now Smith defending. And the basket by Harden.
Hey, guys, a final thought on Kobe. I mean, all the players on that list were heavily...
Yeah, I really don't like what they did with Kobe. He's not scary anymore.
Top guys on that list over someone who's afraid
it's like a normal player. Turnovers for days. It's like you can't trust him anymore.
Just five on the clock. 11 feet away.
Lucky Cooley shot. Made me a lucky ass shot with Kobe.
Kobe's got 9 points now in just the second half. The Kings trail by 10.
Lance.
Harden kicks to Smart.
Oh.
Back to Harden. Tries a three.
Fuck.
And Smart with the basket.
Is that Marcus Smart? Damn, this team is stacked.
Harden's got his third assist on the night. Outside, Kobe.
And James, just leave
Noah
me the
with
fuck
a screen
alone.
On Harden.
Alright, if James wants some here, I call ISO. James wants some.
Ryan
James.
Against Harden.
Yeah, he wants some right now. He really wants to play like this, huh? Oh, I just lost you. Oh, yeah? Where's your cooking shit now?
Kobe can't get that one to fall.
No other way to put it. Just a poor shooting performance for him. But luckily, his teammates have picked up the slack. I mean, you never expect to get opportunities that easy coming down the stretch of a tight game.
Wow. All right.
And here's Clarkson. Noah the screen. Brooks and dishes to Noah. Passes it to Fry. Feeds it to Bryant. Pulls up on the wing. Bryant can't get that one to fall.
I'm shooting too much with Kobe. Fuck. Too many broken plays.
Smart kicks to Harden. Iguodala outside. 55 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. To the middle. Here's Scola. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. Gets the first. That shrinks the margin to just four. And some changes here for the Kings. DeAndre Jordan comes in for Brandon.
Oh my God.
And Smith subbed in for Smart. And then for the Lakers, Pau Gasol has checked in for Fry. Rush comes in for J.R. Smith. And it's Jennings in for Clarkson. Bryant. It's
fucking
in!
Kobe Bear, make that shit.
Now a timeout called by Sacramento. They're losing by five. There's 38 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
They need to get a quick bucket here. If there's more than 24 seconds left afterwards,
no way.
Try for a stop. If there's less,
oh, Kobe with the clutch. Kobe with the clutch.
A chance here to possibly put it out of reach.
This is when you really need to maintain your focus.
Kobe having just a fantastic game. He has 20 points and the assist numbers tremendous.
His court vision is on par with anybody.
What is his stats right now? Damn, okay.
I mean, he could not pass the ball any better than he is right now.
The free throws go down and the lead goes up.
Here's Smith.
Jordan. Damn, that's a turn to superstar. Oh, shit.
Rejected by Gasol.
That boy is a superstar.
And now here comes Kobe, leading the break. About 3 seconds between shot and game clock.
Ooh, Kobe. And the Lakers lead by nine. I keep forgetting I'm supposed to go to your place to buy Ricky Pierce Amiibos.
Timeout called by the Kings.
Amiibos from Peter. I keep forgetting to go to your place and give him the money.
Left in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, he has Amiibos holding for me.
And look, this one's out of reach. I don't know what they're thinking with this timeout.
Neither do I. I mean, maybe they're going over their plans for after the game. Who knows?
Let's just get out of here. See.
And so Los Angeles.
Well, a nice win for you tonight, Joe.
I'm trying to remember what I'm doing Sunday. I feel like I'm not doing anything Sunday, but I feel like I am. I don't know. Post-game show. Oh yeah. I know Saturday.
Thanks, Kevin. So busy now we
at
move
night.
On to our Jordan player
and then
of the game.
Sunday. I'm not sure what I'm doing Sunday, and then Monday I'm busy on Monday
come
too.
Out and control a basketball game like he did.
Is on Sunday,
up, folks. Thanks for joining us for Chicago.
Let me check if I do have something. Not sure if I do. Yeah. Oh damn. Wait, is it true Trayvon just keeps on sleeping at your place? Uncle Tony. Oh, cause like I was drinking with Uncle Tony, and he's like, oh yeah, I have a Trayvon like living here or sometime, and I was like, yeah, that dude, that guy don't hit me up, man. That guy grease me. He's always like working at Alderman Mall and stuff. And Uncle Tony's like, oh yeah, he works, and then most of the time he's sleeping at Kendall's new place. I was like, oh yeah, I was just there. Ding. Who is that guy? I don't know a Traven. Who is that guy? Oh, damn. Oh, yeah, how was Vegas? No strip clubs? Damn. Oh, from the ground? It's cards from the ground, yeah. Oh, he did? Yeah. Oh, should have been like, does Caesar actually lived here? I always want to do that. I'm not balling up to go out of teasers. Party. Oh, I can still party. 25 to 30. The party.
Time in Los Angeles from the Staples Center. All the crowd ready to go as they look to cheer on the Lakers. So for the Lakers, their last game, a win against the Sacramento Kings.
And you know what? Exactly what had to be done in terms of winning on the road. Never allowed any momentum to build up against them. Kept the crowd out of the game. And for every punch they took, they had a counter.
I was very impressed, Greg, with the way they stood their ground. Even when they were on their heels some, coming through those moments where
Get
they
those,
were
please.
Backing up a bit. That's what it takes on the road. You got to show that kind of fortitude and resilience.
Shit.
So let's take a look at the starters for the Dallas Mavericks. Carter Williams is out there with Jeremy Lamb. And then there's Antetokounmpo. Then there's Griffin. And it's Howard in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And so the Los Angeles Lakers get the first points of the ball game.
Well, that was a quick foul for him there. The refs are certainly calling it close.
Carter Williams against Jennings. shot from 12. It's good, and there's a block called on the play. He'll get one free throw.
Wow, got that one off right in the face of the big fella. Nice quick fire release.
Yeah, and the mid-range shot really the only option in that situation. Sometimes when you're facing a bigger guy, you can't get it all the way to the rim.
Now here's Jennings. No one near him. A shot by Clarkson, no good.
Damn.
And guys, the Greek Freak really improved his numbers across the board last season.
Shit.
Giannis was up in every measurable category except three-point percentage.
He's really improved his shooting, though, overall. The three ball still eludes him a little bit here and there. But what I like, Kevin, is his aggressiveness. That's what's making the difference in his game right now.
Oh.
Here's Clarkson.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
The Rim Rattler.
Just a remarkable jam. These fans' jaws are on the ground right now.
That's straight up Showtime stuff right there, baby. Major highlight reel material. Nice work on the inside. Hard to get that one up and over the big fella.
Well, it's not supposed to be easy down there, and a little artistry on the inside helped him make it happen.
Did Kendall Brandon beat up someone at UW? At the UW area? He beat someone up. Okay, first of all, Brandon was having a bad day because Brandon's dad hired his Mexican to like fix his coolant on his car or something. And this Mexican fucked it up. He left the cap open. So he was like in the middle of the road causing traffic because his car is all smoky and just won't start. So he had to push the car himself. And no one would help him push the car. People are just like saying that you're a fucking bad driver or something. And finally a black guy helps him out. And what was it? Is that the parking lot or something? And yeah, some guy was laughing at. Oh no, Brady opened the hood and he was looking at himself, and then the hood landed or like dropped on his head, and the guy saw it and he was laughing at him, and Brandon's like, go fuck off or something. And the guy was like, what'd you say to me? No, this random guy. This is a random guy. Like, he just saw Brandon get hit with his head. Anyways, yeah, He's like, go fuck off. And then the guy was like, what are you saying to me? And he changed it to, fuck you. And then he went up to him. Or the guy went up to Brandon and go face to face. And then he whooped his ass and kicked him in the face. And there's like all blood everywhere. Like hella blood. And he's like, yo, man, I'm going to go get my homies. And you're dead, man. I'm going to kill you or some shit.
Adams, he's checked in for Griffin.
I was like, damn, Brandon.
For Giannis Antetokounmpo. Joey Meeks, he's checked in for
today, like in the morning.
For Carter Williams.
Yeah.
Now, here is Smith.
He said, we're going to kill you. Like, get my homies. We're going to get you or something. I was like, damn, Brandon, calm down. He's like, no, I'm done with this shit.
And here's Jennings, the fast break opportunity. And slammed in.
It's like, I'm so fed up.
Well, they weren't going to pass up that chance to get out and run following.
Kick him in the face? Because he's so fed up.
They've got to pad their lead anytime an opportunity.
You don't mess with him. He has a temper. Yeah, he like socked.
Here's me.
Yeah, he socked him and just swung and is on the ground. And he looks like Eminem. He's like an Eminem guy. He has like a black hat, a Seahawk jacket, and yeah, he whooped his ass.
Shot is off.
And Brandon's all hella scared. What do you call it? Because he might got his license plate or something. I told him, go pull a Walter White, shave your head, throw your clothes away or something. You gotta lose that car. Burn that car.
It really has, Clark. The defense unable to react as quickly as necessary in terms of.
But then Jewer's like. Like all agents look alike, and Brand's like, yeah, Brand's like, oh, that's true, I'm safe then.
And for the Lakers against the rest
like,
of the
I don't know, man.
They only went 9-40.
What they all say
in their own conference matches.
Yeah, and never a good sign when less than half of your wins come against your own conference.
The kick him in the face.
They have a long road ahead of them to get back to their years of Western Conference dominance.
And Dallas calls their first timeout of the game.
Well, Well, you know, the Mavs made the playoffs last season, but they really had a hard time against the rest of the Western Conference contenders, in part because they struggled defensively.
Hey, what did,
they were pretty good, but they didn't
even care about this league, huh? When they needed. You're going to beat them in the toilet bowl. That was my Super Bowl. I don't know what you guys are talking about.
Now here's Rivers.
That was my Super Bowl. I just wanted to beat him.
Vicious to set the low shot.
I finally did.
To the wing on the left.
Holy fuck.
Jennings against Rivers. Up and in on the layup. Rivers has got his first points of the night. Greg, you talked about what the Mavs did, how they played against the West, 29-23 record against the rest of the conference.
Oh, man.
Kevin, it's a little misleading, the win total. I mean, if you look at the Mavs against the teams that they compare themselves to, which are the playoff teams in the West, they're only 10-18 over the course of the season.
Good point.
Well, I tell you what, the post play has been rock solid right off the bat.
It really has, and they've created a lot of high percentage shots in the paint here already.
It's Jennings with the drive. Over to the wing. Passes to Smith. On deep.
Damn.
In Los Angeles.
Against Mavs?
You could not diagram a better
I'm facing them right now. I'm facing them right now. They say they have the number one D. Their bench is ass. Their bench is ass. I'm like owning them right now. But when they start in, they keep up just a little bit. Because they got Blake and Dwight, man. The offensive rebound.
The older brother of Blake Griffin, 3 years older. You know, he played, as did Blake, for their dad, Tommy, in high school. And they were terrific high school players and four-time state champions.
I mean, it always helps to have a big brother who's kind of been there and done that.
If you let Kobe do that, then this team is ass. Let Kobe do that.
Player either, and also a college coach.
Welcome back, folks. We'll see if we're in store for a more tightly contested quarter as we move here into the second. And let's get your take, guys, in the hustle stats for the Lakers.
Well, I think the defensive aggressiveness on display here has caught him off guard.
Playing air-tight
defense and coming up with the steal.
Also, how about the fact defensively,
like the other 2Ks, man, I'll just dominate the fuck out of this guy.
Especially in this first half.
Pau Gasol is out there with Bryant. Then there's Jordan Clarkson. Then there's Jennings.
And
it's Noah in at the five. That's the group for the Lakers to start the second quarter. And guys, Blake Griffin has got to be one of the more humble stars in the league. You rarely hear about off-court issues in interviews.
Wow, Blake, really?
Comes off kind of as a regular guy.
That's the way it appears to me, Kevin. The young man has his head screwed on pretty tight and both feet on the ground. He started out as a class act, and he stayed one.
A wide open look for Gasol. Kicks it to Clarkson.
Mm-hmm.
He gets stolen by Lamb. And now approaching 2 minutes of action here in the second quarter. The feed now to Carter Williams. He kicks to Lamb. Pass to Griffin. By Gasol, and he's able to get it back.
That's it.
World Peace is checked in for Los Angeles. Los Angeles leading by 8. Outside Bryant. And here in the second, 2 minutes gone by. Los Angeles with another miss.
Shit.
And talking about Blake Griffin, one of the more well-liked players in our league, but also one of the most teed up players. Top.
And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game right now.
There is a swagger out here on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either.
That's right.
I tell you what, I used to love to go up and jam like that.
Dallas calls timeout.
You know, obviously, you know, there's some things out there he does not like and wants to talk it over.
Well, Greg, you play and you envision yourself as a coach as well. So, you know, sometimes you need to make some adjustment.
Brandon Jennings, he's checked in for Los Angeles. Griffin's shot is good.
The plan of attack is obvious. Get the ball inside and go strong to the rim.
And Greg, you know, the defense has been very slow to adapt. I mean, that's 10 straight points now inside.
Outside, Kobe.
Let me get this guy, man. I ain't nothing.
On the left block. And the basket good.
Yeah.
Bryant's got 4 points this quarter.
He has created some terrific opportunities for himself and really made the most of it.
Two straight seasons of no playoffs for the Lakers after last year's miss. Not what they were hoping for.
It's going to be a growing process, Kevin. I mean, they had a young team and an injured superstar in Kobe both years.
Hard to make. Oh, damn.
Wow, the floor just really opened
up. Oh, that's ESPN status.
Yeah, I mean, I'm all for good offense, but that was just a terrible reaction from the defense.
Carter Williams against Jennings. Here's Lamb, and it's off from three-point range. And here again, Los Angeles in transition up a
fucking court spot in my alley.
And then fucking Griffin play. With the dunk.
Hey guys, got careless with the ball there, and the turnover leads to the big stuff.
Once he came upright with the steal, he went straight on the attack.
That's exactly the way to do it, too, Kevin. Go hard to the bucket, and don't let them set up the defense.
Antetokounmpo kicks to Griffin. They set the screen. Sefolosha dishes to Carter Williams. Griffin sets the screen for Carter Williams. Rebounded by the Lakers. Noah's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Bryant drives in.
And you know, one thing that comes to mind his incredible dedication. I mean, you wonder if that. That has turned off potential.
Finish this game.
Maybe he's a bit too competitive, but you know, when you're in the business of competing, hard for me to imagine you can be too competitive.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles. Channing Frye's checked in for Noah. Caspi comes in for Pau Gasol. Brandon Rush. He's checked in for Brandon Jennings.
Oh, shit.
And Smith subbed in for Jordan Clarkson.
You know, the defense has got to do a much better job of fighting over those screens.
And, Greg, especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
And that one's good. 14 points for Kobe Bryant. With Kobe and his competitiveness, it is something that he's coped with. Said it took him a while in the league. Clark to realize not everyone loves basketball as much as he does.
Yeah, you know, even if you don't have the same kind of drive that has propelled Kobe all these years, I think you have to respect him for it. Shouldn't be a problem for potential free agents, in my opinion.
Really?
And Kobe Bryant gets the whistle that time. That'll be his second foul of the game. There's 47 seconds left in the first half. And Adams kicks to Meeks. Lock at six. Howard, the pass to Rivers. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. Austin Rivers traded to the Clippers last year. A change of scenery did him well, and he was comfortable coming off the bench.
And that's a great point, Kevin. I mean, he seemed to get steady playing time, and that's what he needed most. And also, he wasn't defined by position. They were able to find a niche role for him to play in.
It's a four-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. Adams' shot is good.
It really does make the game easy for your teammates when you can lead them to the rim that well with a pass.
Smith for three. Again, the miss by Smith.
Not able to find it here in the second. He's off stride and off track just a bit after that one he had earlier.
And here's Sefolosha for three. Good work defensively by Smith. Lakers shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
Yeah, last year, collectively, only 74% from the line.
And those aren't the kind of numbers they can afford to repeat throughout this season.
He's off on the second. Rivers. No luck. That'll do it for the first.
Well, Pau, tell him.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Your Lakers, 36. The Rams, 25.
We welcome you back. Surprise, surprise. Incredible work in this one by 14 points. All right, and that'll do it for us here. We now take you back to the...
we're getting back to the action now. It's been a one-team show so far. We'll see if that changes here in the third. You look at Kobe Bryant in this game. I mean, he has been everywhere.
You just love it when the decision-making is as good as it was there in that first half. Didn't force anything.
Guys, I think here in the second half, though, they may want him to be a little more assertive. Start hunting more for his shot, even the tough one.
And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball. On the floor right now for the Mavericks, they've got Howard.
Damn.
He's out there with Antetokounmpo. It's Jeremy Lamb. And it's Carter Williams in a point.
And, folks, he does more than just put 2 points onto their lead. He does it with a little bit of flair.
He sure does. You're right. It's a dazzling move to the bucket for him.
I'll tell you what, he may not be the biggest man in the league, guys, but he more than makes up for that lack of size with amazing aerial skills.
Damn.
Wow, and that sort of showmanship is just deflating right now to a team trying Clark to get back into this game like this.
Yeah, definitely a jam with emphasis. A big apostrophe or exclamation point. How about maybe even a question mark, partner?
Yeah, I would have to say there are a lot of questions right now from a defensive standpoint. That's for sure. And guys, Dwight Howard's an interesting guy. One of the most physically imposing players in our league. And yet he's known for his lighthearted, almost playful nature.
Andrew Howard, his parents raised him to keep a smile on his face and stay upbeat, remain positive. He's done all those things. Competed in the rough and tumble
like
world of pro basketball.
Yeah, and yet some of his peers and contemporaries have gone at him. Durant, for instance, Kobe Bryant called himself, Byron Scott, questioned his desire. Guys go about their work in different manners.
Howard with a screen on Jennings. Over in the corner, Antetokounmpo. He feeds it to Griffin. Rejected by Gasol. And oh, here we go. Jennings with nobody back.
Damn.
Now that's how to finish the break. Throw down with force.
And how's that for some ups coming from that one?
Well, he is a rarity among NBA point guards in his ability to elevate.
Yeah, his athletic ability, guys, is really what takes him a notch above most players at his position.
Gasol with the steal. Side, Kobe.
Let's go. It's and one, baby.
Contact on the shot, so we will go to the line. A 3-point play chance here.
Go.
Kobe Bryant is such a great all-around player. I mean, if there's one thing people don't talk about, it's his passing. He's fourth overall in assists amongst active players.
Here's the screen. Over to the left wing. With the floater to end the run. Noah with the block. Carter Williams against Jennings. He tries for three.
There you go.
And there's Kobe. That's good on the assist by Jennings. 20 points for Kobe Bryant. And going back to Kobe Bryant, guys, he had to learn the same thing that Michael Jordan had to learn on his own. To win championships, you have to trust your teammates and not take everything upon yourself.
Wow.
Kobe learned from the best and played with some of the best. So you can't ask for a better way to spend a career.
Rebounded by Howard. Howard's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Here's Carter Williams. Griffin a screen on Bryant. Carter Williams dishes to Griffin. Now here's Kobe, the fast break opportunity.
Let's go, and one.
And the officials whistle a foul on the
we
shot.
We go and one today.
It's good.
Let him know, Kobe.
To the line. And a new group getting ready for Dallas. Adams, he's checked in for Howard. Cephalosha comes in for Antetokounmpo. Jody Meeks, he's checked in for Lamb. And it's Austin Rivers in for Carter Williams. And Meeks kicks to Griffin. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. The Lakers on offense. They're on a 17-6 run. Right wing. Here's Clarkson.
Dang.
At three off the mark. Mavericks trail by 20. Mavericks last season, Clark, were very tough down the stretch in games, and a lot of players that shined all the time during crunch time.
Well, when you've got guys like Dirk and Monte that can create their own shot, it gives you a chance to win close games. It's a big reason they were 6-0 in overtime games, in my opinion.
1:49 left to play in the third. There's the three.
Let's go.
That's good. Clarkson's got 9 points here in the second half.
And just a little bit ragged defensively there, Clark.
And last year, not exactly up to Noah's lofty standards. He's way down in field goal percentage and free throw percentages compared to the season before, but he did not play completely healthy all of last year either.
A little dinged up, missed 13 games more than he had the season prior, and also the minutes dropped as well. And you could just see him laboring at times on the floor, clearly affected by those injuries.
Ooh.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring.
Polk loose. Rivers kicks to Cephalosia.
Oh,
that's in the tray.
Like that, huh?
Cephalosia's got himself
like
a 3 there.
Boy, I tell you what, he loves getting looks like that from the 3-point line. No one near him. That's a warm-up jumper for him.
What the hell?
Oh, here we go with Griffin. Nobody up there.
Excellent night from Griffin. 12 points and the one steal. He's been their leader, stirring the drink at the offensive end and then anchoring the defense.
And yeah, Clark, what an example he's been setting out there.
Big group substitution here for the Lakers. Channing Frye's checked in for Noah. World Peace comes in for Pau Gasol. Brandon Rush, he's checked in for Kobe. And Smith subbed in for Brandon Jennings. Clarkson kicks to Frye. Gets an open look and hits. Frye's got his second bucket of the night.
And, you know, going back to Noah last season, I think the additions to the Bulls' front court had an effect on him. I mean, they added Gasol and Mirotić, two major talents up front. I think that gave Noah less opportunities than he'd had the year before, and it was an adjustment for him.
Cephalosia passes to Griffin. 4 on the clock. No luck, they battled on the glass, but couldn't knock it down. And it's the Lakers on the
Smith
with the ball. But they recover it. Pass to Rush. And stolen by Cephalosia.
Come on, man.
And we're getting underway here in the fourth quarter. The scoreboard tells the story in this matchup. But we'll see how much things change up here. Mavericks trailed by 21. Jordan Clarkson is out there with Jennings. Then it's Pau Gasol. Then there's Kobe. And it's Noah in at the 5. Home in the paint. That's who's in the game for the Lakers. Noah with the block. Here's Clarkson. Here he comes, and there he goes.
Look at him punish that
rack. Check out the fellas. Check out his teammates over on the bench. So they are going crazy.
Back to Carter Williams.
And one thing that I know a lot of fans are worried about is NBA jerseys with ads on them. It's something the NBA has explored more in-depth recently and would be another stream of revenue for the league.
Here's Lamb. Just 3 to shoot. And they force the shot clock violation. Great team. Lakers leading by 23. Outside Jennings. The dish now to Gasol. And the rebound goes to Howard. Howard's got 9 rebounds now tonight. And with the ads on the jerseys, it isn't something that would sit well with the fans probably, but around the globe, almost every other league in the world has ads on their jerseys.
You know, the NBA has shown that they're willing to try new things with jerseys, much like they've looked at other issues. It started with the sleeve jerseys, and advertisements is just another area they're exploring.
Right side, Gasol. It's back to Jennings. Kobe draws the double. Outside, Jennings. Gasol against Howard. The 9-foot shot. And the shot clock
back.
Expires.
Okay,
24-second
okay.
violation.
I take it.
Just over a minute and a half played here in the fourth. Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
Off target with the jump hook.
Oh, excellent interior D to force the miss.
His defensive ability is a big factor. I mean, there's no denying that.
Gasol setting the pick for Kobe.
Oh, why do you... Why? That animation, why?
2-on-1 as they jump out on the break.
Nope.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the Lakers.
Guys, the passing we've seen from them has been tremendous. Very unselfish.
Yeah, but also, they haven't missed a beat in terms of their fast break game. That's been equally as effective all night long.
And Lamb drops them both. And guys, over his first three seasons, no question, Jeremy Lamb has been a major disappointment. Clark, his game simply didn't seem to evolve at all over that time.
Well, that's why scouting is an inexact science. You know, he was a major piece of that game.
Oh, I like it. I like that shot. Pump. Ooh. Bang, bang.
Harden trade that 3 years back, but just hasn't found the traction anticipated for him.
Feeds it to Cephalosha. Back to Carter Williams. And that one's good.
Really, the defense is helpless to stop a layup right there. Just too much of an advantage in terms of the mismatch.
Gasol setting the pick for Kobe. Gasol fires. That's good. And it's Kobe with the assist. Bryant's got 3 assists tonight.
Just 3?
He hasn't really done much on the offensive end, but he's worked within the team concept to help them get the lead. He's done some other things other than scoring to help his team get the lead here.
And not a night he's going to want to remember, just not really able to score the basketball.
Mavericks have gone just 2 of 8 in this fourth quarter. The final quarter not treating them well so far. The shot by Adetokounmpo. Nobody around. Great touch on the 16-footer. Adetokounmpo's got 4 this quarter. Outside, Kobe from deep. Adetokounmpo pulls it in. Mavericks trail by 20. Howard kicks to Carter Williams. There's the screen. Terrific design on the pick play, and he lays it in.
And that's why it's so important to really be a good screening team. You get a lot of open looks from it.
Gasol a screen. Gasol setting the pick for Bryant. Offside Gasol. The 17-footer. And he gets it to go. And the Lakers lead by 20.
No hesitation. When he saw the space the D was giving him, that's 2.
And the Mavericks call time here.
Pau Gasol was the number 3 pick back in 2001. He managed to average 18-9 his first season, was rookie of the year, became a perennial all-star. There's no way his younger brother, Mark, who was a second-round pick, could ever match up to that, right? Not so fast, people. Mark's pretty good, too.
Blake Griffin, he's checked in for Thabo Sefolosha. Los Angeles leading by 20. All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
Yes, thanks, guys. I got a chance to hear what Rick Carlisle was saying to the team. He made no mistake that their plan was to run their offense through Blake Griffin. When coach addressed the guys in the huddle, his message was clear. Quote, he's who we want getting the ball up the
table.
He is who we want making our decisions. With the minutes ticking down and the deficit still a big one, those adjustments have to be a chance worth taking, Kevin.
Thank you, Doris. Talking about Pau and brother Mark, both of them were excellent last season. The difference is that Pau has always been considered a great prospect, so detractors are much harder on him when they see cracks, I think, Greg, in his game.
Yeah, you know, for Marc Gasol, it can only exceed expectations because they started out so low. I'd simply say that if I had to pick between one or the other for best career, I'd do everything I could to pick both.
Good way to get out of it. Good answer.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance, and it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for Los Angeles.
Agreed, Steve, and as one-sided as it gets today. You know, Clark, there were some dominant moments in about every facet of this game for that team.
You're right, Kevin. It's hard to think of anything that didn't go right for them. I mean, game planning by the coaches, execution by the players, everything was spot on.
And so with this, they'll end up with their second win on the year.
And once it becomes official, this win gives them a nice confidence boost against this team. They'll face them twice more this season.
Wow. The stats tell us, Greg, that the winner of the first game is a big favorite to come out on top in the overall series.
A fantastic show. And what an amazing all-around game it was for Kobe Bryant. He was doing everything right, and the points came in bunches. Definitely had the hot hand.
And here is Carter Williams. Off target with that shot. And so it's the...
Thank you, Kevin.
The 2K Sports postgame show.
Thank you, Kevin. And now we have the opportunity to present our Jordan player of the game, Kobe Bryant. He showed the composure and cleverness that only a longtime veteran could possess. A vintage performance from a very savvy player.
Look, how many times have we seen games like this from Kobe? He was the primary option. They needed a bucket, he delivered. His game has evolved in the last few years, but the recipe was working tonight.
He was up to every single challenge he faced tonight. He was in such control of the ball game. His showcase of his skill set was awesome.
And that wraps things up, folks. Thanks for joining us. For Shaquille O'Neal.